Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to the Scrolls Daggerfall. Today we are in Koegria. I decided to not go into the Fighter's Guild in Wayrest because we have been getting sent to, you know, the similar dungeons over and over again, so I decided let's try another province since I was in Koegria for some potions anyway. Since the House of Tabella is here, that's the only place where I can buy some potions. An oversight, I would personally say, when it comes to designing this game, for roleplay purposes at least. But anyway, I digress. We are going inside the Fighter's Guild in hopes of finding new dungeons to read so that you know, we can keep things fresh and gain the next rank. So, what's the time right now? It could be 9 o'clock, so we need to report it for 2 hours. Any enemies around me? None that I can see. Just this one who's still been waiting around for the past 2 hours, I don't know why. But at any rate, let's go in. I always forget who this guy is. Anyway, the progress of this guy is over, so let's wait. Let me just save it. In case I get some, like, unattainable quest. I am Pristister Greenham. That is a difficult name to pronounce. I have a relatively menial job, if you're willing to take it. Actually, really? It's the rat infestation quest. I forgot the name of the quest, but Koegria is the best pawn shop. Alright. I guess it's another chance for us to level up our hand-to-hand skills. Speaking of, what other skills do we need to level up? A short blade and hand-to-hand are at par, so maybe we can update our archery skills this time around. Now, Loki at Koegria's best pawn shop. Didn't mean to get all on your face, sir, but since you're here already. Koegria's best pawn shop. Do I have it marked on the map? Is the question. I suppose not. I guess we just have to ask these people as to where the actual pawn shop is. That's where you can have it, sir. Location of Koegria's best pawn shop. Right here. Yeah. It's somewhere awfully close by. It would be best if I marked Koegria's best pawn shop on the map. Thank you so much, Katsu. So where is it again? Should be somewhere around here, right? I mean, this guy did say it's awfully close by. I can't see it anywhere. It's like outside of Koegria. Ah, right here. So we head straight to south, I suppose. Yes, yes we do. Alright, time to get on our high horse. Let's chase this back. I forgot the term for these things. I think it's called a gorgo, I'm not sure. Or maybe a handcuff. I used to have a lot of those when I was a kid. We don't use them as much these days, but mostly just fried over at a fountain. Koegria's best pawn shop seems to be this building right here, if I'm not mistaken. No, it's the one next to it. I wasn't mistaken, but at any rate. Time to pull out a bow, and this is where the rat infestation is, right? The rat or bat infestation, or whatever you might want to call it. Wait, no? I thought that's pretty much where I was supposed to go. Was it? I was surprised because typically it's the case that they don't exactly. Oh, yeah, here it is. Now, what I'm afraid of is shooting that person over there. Okay. So it is actually bad this time around. Again, more giant bats, one of them is right here. Am I missing or something? That one's dead. My archery isn't that high, like, it hasn't been upgraded as high. And another thing would be the fact that I think using like an elven bow, so yeah, it makes it a little difficult. Another missing component to this questline is the fact that they don't always tell you when the mission is over. Oh, here's some bats. Again. No, I would hate to attack you, sir. That is the last thing that I want to do. You've got a lectern for some reason. Maybe this guy was a professor. Or maybe he still is a professor. Thing is, you just stand around at a certain place and the game more or less essentially spawns the damn things for you. Am I missing? I think I am missing, aren't I? Do I need to like switch to like using my hands? I think I do. I think I do. Let's make it this and yeah, thank you. Of course, I don't expect that one to have any pressure, but essentially you just keep roaming around and you stand in one place long enough, the game will just spawn the enemies right next to you. And that's essentially how this questline goes. I see another, let me try using this. I started climbing backwards, that is... that's a first. I didn't expect to be climbing backwards actually. Yeah, I don't think the boo was a good choice for these environments. But let us make it even dirty before we decide to switch over to our hands and fists. Well, our fists and cuffs. Giant bat has died. Oh, another one of you. Giant bat has died again. No treasure. What was I even expecting? I don't know why I expected the body to have treasure of some sort. Now here's the problem with this. As long as I can loiter around like this, archery has improved, hand-to-hand has improved. I would sure hope so. Let's just go ahead and check this out once more and see if there are any stragglers that we need to take care of. Because as far as this quest goes, you're supposed to get a message that says that you are actually done with the quest. But yeah, the message never comes because of bugs. And you're essentially just left doing nothing. I'm guessing that we are done, because otherwise the game would have probably spawned in like at least one more enemy up until now. I see. Interesting. I wonder if people are going to be afraid to approach me when I have a fist drawn. They are. They recognize them as weapons. That brings me pleasure. Hi, doggy. You look rabbit. I got nothing against dogs in the street, but that one looks rabid. With the red eyes and everything. The fighter's go, let us report the quest back in. Hopefully it has been completed. Sometimes it's difficult to find the entrance unless you already know where it is. Killing bats even giant ones doesn't take much skill, but it does pay the same, eh? Right then. Let's get a next quest. I got a good job for you. I wouldn't give this to just anyone, but I know you do good work. It's a pack of giants that want killing. Please pay the standard 502 gold pieces. You offer it? Of course, good deal, Grimfangs. A client pays the giants at the stronghold, the Cairn of Morulum. He says there are six of them and he ain't gonna pay unless all six are stepped in 7 days. Got it, Grimfangs? Good. Right, so. Yet again, this is one of those quests where you keep searching for the quest objective and you just essentially stumble onto them. Like, the point isn't to, like, roam through the dungeons looking for the targets. It's rather to just stay in one place and let the targets come to you. As soon as you can clear the dungeon enough to a point where you can find a place to rest, keep loitering. Keep loitering there and the giants will just keep going to you. The Cairn of Morulum. Right. It has been a while since I've forgotten the name of the place, but yeah. The Cairn of Morulum. Open three drones in the box, okay. And exploring the dungeons can be fulfilling in and of itself, but it doesn't really get you much apart from that. Like, apart from the loot that you can garner. So, here's what I'm gonna do. First, I'm gonna save here. And then, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna keep looting the dungeon until I can't loot anymore. Oh, hi! I ate an orc yesterday. It tasted good. I wonder if I can understand all of this because I'm getting better in Giantish, or just as a consequence of, you know, events. At any rate, what the block is here. So, potion of reaction. I hope I still have potions of reaction. Yeah, right here. Like, these guys' success rates when it comes to cursing you is hideous. So, yeah, you better get ready to, you know, be on the receiving end of some punishment if you are looking to fight ghosts. Right there. Saving it. I feel like there's a hidden door here in this room. No? If you say so. What about the passage there though? No hidden doors? Okay. So the first giant you fight it immediately, the second one onwards you're gonna have to struggle a little. Because the game isn't going to, like, just give you the giants. It's gonna make you spend time in the dungeon for them to try and find them, essentially. And that is where the entire waiting game comes into play. Yeah, let's go in here. Of course, there's nothing in here. Seems linear thus far, but I know how Dungeons & Daggerfall can quickly change in a hurry, so I'm not gonna say anything much about that. And the only reason I'm exploring is so that I get enough loot to where I need to wait in the place. For a second there I thought I was cursed. Apparently not. Oh, I completely forgot. I should probably be undeniable access, right? I should probably be wearing this shirt instead. I mean, I can use the wisdom boost, but I read that it doesn't really do anything for you, so yeah. Apart from that, what else did I want to? Should we? Might as well, right? Because it is a sword in the end. Or should we just save it for later, so the endgame? Yeah, let's do that. Let's save it for the endgame, so let's use this for now. The dwarven broadsword. But herein lies the trouble that if this game mostly consists of unlootable enemies, in that instance, we don't really get a lot of loot. That should bring out another giant. No? I guess I'll just come back here and rest again. Where's the enemy? Waiting for the giant. Right then. Yeah, let's go down. I see a wraith. I have heard it before I saw it, but I see a wraith. Sometimes these guys have treasure. Not all the time, but sometimes these guys do have treasure. This should probably be like a hidden door here. Good thing is it isn't locked. I'll come with the supplies, I'll take them. Because they don't really take up much loot in my inventory, and they're useful for marking places. For example, right now. Let's drop this here. This spotted part. And drop this here. No, when I get bored, I'll just go ahead and start lodging around in one place. I think I see a ghost. I don't know why that ice dragon shows up at the bottom like that. But I think it has something to do with the fact that the ghost tried to paralyze me. I see a wraith. No treasure, again. Any loot? Seems to be. These ones I try to avoid getting them because they're 1.5 kilograms, so they take up a lot of space in inventory. Now then, any hidden doors or anything of that sort? Okay. Let's try lodging here for a while. See if that brings about a giant. Ah, there you are. Now, one of the things about this game is the fact that usually these giants tend to have some of the other kind of, you know, loot for you. Where's the giant? I can hear the giant. I'm guessing he's inside this door. Where did you come through? Like, how did you manage to come through without me noticing it? But it seems like these guys don't really have a lot of loot either. I'm guessing that's sort of the fault of the dungeon itself. Hi there. At least these guys are cool, so I'll give them that. Credit for going to see. Hi there. I mean, I realize this is mostly just cheating the game, but yeah, this, I mean, this is like a much smarter strategy to do things, because otherwise you're gonna be like just exploring the dungeon until it's you know, time for you to leave. All of the giants are dead. Ooh. And I got no loot. Welcome. Time to head back. I mean, this dungeon was mostly linear, so that's one thing. Really? Well, I don't really care to engage you, so I'll just let you be there. And this here would be the exit. No, not really. I have to go back home. An earthly moon. A giant something something. Koegria. Okay. Koegria. At least I got a variety in quests this time around, so that's something that I'm happy about. Because typically, I don't even get that, like a variety in quests. Okay. No enemies here. And I'm assuming, yes, I am, so I'm assuming I'm at this side of the wall, so let's go ahead and read what this placard has to say. Just go ahead here. No plague or pestilence here either. It seems to be something that is plagued by such distress. I wonder what happened there. Like, they're being cursed by. I forgot the name of the god, the Danger Lord of Plague and Pestilence. But yeah, they, when she or he, I don't know exactly what it is, I mean, they don't exactly have a gender, they just appear in front of you whenever they please. So yeah, I guess we'll lodge for 3 more hours here. The loitering game, that's what the Sentai quest should be called. Ah, a lamb to the slaughter, eh? Let me try parrying. Ah. Caroloria Buckingsmith. Buckingsmith. Caroloria Buckingsmith says, "You're much tougher than Alyssa said you would be." Alyssa, eh? So that's like a rival clue to who's been attacking me. Alyssa. And I wonder why Alyssa is getting involved in all of these affairs. A betrayal by Wayrest, huh? After all I've done for them. I'm a goddamn marshal at your place. Let's see what this says. Kill Grimfangs before too much is learned. Use any means. Woodbone. So this apparently is some sort of connection between a listener and Lord Woodbone. Plot thickens? The plot thickens. The plot doth thicken. Series. It seems that ever since I came to Koegria that the route hasn't been that good. I wonder if it's because of more, it's more impoverished province, but I didn't get. I'm gonna load up two more hours. I mean, I could load up for 2-3 more hours, but that would be excessive. I'd have to wait like 2 extra seconds to finish loitering before I can like hit him. By the beard of Thoric, the giants didn't know what hit him, did they? In fact, here's a 502 gold, 502 gold, as promised. Right then, you got something else for me? Congratulations, Grimfangs, because of your outstanding weaponry prowess, we have promoted you to the rank of Defender in the Guild. Among other benefits, this increase means cheaper weapon repair and more profitable work assignments. Thank you, I guess. And yeah, that's it. I don't really want any more work. That's pretty much what I set out to do here. This was a short run. Sort of glad it was. And I mean, I do want to play more at this point. I mean, I'm not satisfied with the amount of time that I've already played this game for. Hi there, kitty. Can I grab you? No? Okay. So yeah, I mean, I do want to go on more quests. Maybe, do I really want to? Yeah, I can't. I was thinking maybe I might want to exactly until I get to the next rank of the fighter skill, but apparently we need to wait for a few days until, you know, I think we need to wait for 9 days, or I think a month between, a month between promotions. So yeah, we're gonna have to wait a bit until the next promotion. So with that being said, this is it for today's video. Thank you very much for tuning in, thank you for watching, and thank you for sticking around until the end. The next time that we come back, we will be covering the quest that I did, Toggle. Don't bite me, yeah? Yeah, good, thank you. Am I healthy? Yes, I am healthy. I haven't contracted the plague yet because of the rats. Anyway, as I was saying, so the next time we come back, we will be covering the soul of the Lich quest, the one that the Underking gave us. I mean, he did summon us to his domain. We have just been, like, he did that a long time ago. We've just been delaying it up until now because I didn't exactly want to, well, how do I put this, address that quest yet. Being sort of concerned with how it's going to be difficult for us. But yeah, now that we are at a higher level, I think the quest unlocks at level 7, but since we are at a higher level right now, we might as well go ahead and try that quest on this ice. So yeah, until then, take care. Fare thee well, fellow Earthlings.